And every Thursday, we invite you to phone in your medical questions and concerns. And Dr. Kalani Brady volunteers his time to get here from the Johnny School of Birds and Medicine and also all the other things that you do. You go to Kalaupapa, you go to Queens, you're everywhere.
Everywhere.
You're like Chicken Man. Remember Chicken Man?
Yes.
Uncle He's everywhere. He's everywhere. Okay, let's get to the questions. I have a friend who has MRSA, and she's a home caregiver. How do I prevent it from getting? Can she get it? Is MRSA?
Methicillin-resistant Staphylococcus aureus. That's mm-hmm. what MRSA is. It's an organism, it's a bacteria, which is hard to treat with antibiotics. And the best way is lots of hand washing and avoid direct body contact.
Okay. I have diabetes gustatory.
Gustatory,
sweating. Not necessarily with the spicy food. Is there anything I can do to treat this?
Ron, this is a very frustrating condition for those that have it. It means if you eat, you break out in a sweat. Wow. And now some of us eat, and if it's spicy food, we break out. But these diabetics, unfortunately, break out all the time.
Wow.
It's hard to treat. There are surgical procedures which have some success where you cut nerves and basically dry out the sweating. But generally, makeup cosmetics are the way that most people treat it.
I'd imagine you don't want to do that because sweat is like protection for us, our body trying to cool off.
In most cases.
In most cases, okay. Any home remedy before I call my doctor for a prescription? I'm 65 years old. I had my first gout attack last night.
I'd worry that it might not be gout. So I'd go in, the doctor went to medical school for a reason, did a residency for a reason. Let's make sure it's gout before we decide to treat it with over-the-counter remedies.
Not a good time to self-diagnose.
No.
I'm 67, and when I walk, my back starts hurting, and when I stop, the pain goes away. What's happening here?
I don't know. I think it's best that the patient go in to see their doc and do an examination. And with the tools from the examination, we might have an accurate diagnosis. But I wouldn't just suffer with it at home.
Okay, I think my son has a bladder infection. Should I take him to the ER?
I would bet that it would be best to take him to his regular primary physician. ER is a second choice, but I certainly wouldn't let this young boy suffer at home with a bladder infection just trying to flush it out.
Okay, let's get to more. What is the difference between osteoarthritis and rheumatoid arthritis? Are treatments the same?
Treatments are not the same. Osteoarthritis is the wear and tear of joints with age. Rheumatoid arthritis is a much more serious disease generally, where the body fights itself and the war zone is the joint. There are very powerful rheumatoid arthritis medications that can stop it from destroying the joints themselves and should be under a care of a rheumatologist for rheumatoid arthritis.
Okay, I'm 57 years old. I have cataracts with a glare. What are the risks?
You know, the surgery that we do for cataracts is really safe. I've had both my cataracts out, and thank goodness, now I don't have to worry about that glare when I'm driving at night, when it's raining. It really restores your eyesight.
Okay. Besides all of your work, your great work as a doctor and a physician and an educator, you do other things as well. I know you got an event coming up that you'd like to talk
yes,
about.
Yes, on Saturday. This Saturday, from 8 to noon at Hilton Hawaiian Village in the Coral Ballroom for free.
Uh-huh.
There is Valentine in Paradise on heart health, lots of experts, and maybe a secret expert that we may have in addition to our regular experts. It's free. Call 522-3469 to register.
Okay. Surprise guest, huh?
Yes.
You're not going to let us know?
Nope.
No? All right. Come in.